Right, well, I've got this. You can't. Here. Or that YouTube allows this on, because I've got music on the background, otherwise I won't be able to upload this to YouTube. So, yeah. Right, I'm going to draw a French Bulldog. I haven't drawn for quite a while, so you have to bear with me, and I'm just going to go with it. I'll probably flip from eye to ear to ear to eye to nose to everywhere. I'm using Fabriano artistico paper. I've got my outline, so I'm not drawing straight from just my own whatever. I'm wearing my glove, and here we go. Right, so this is the dog I am drawing. Cutie! I wanted to draw a French Bulldog. So, as usual with me, I start off with the eyes. I'm going to start off like I say, I haven't drawn for quite a while, so I'm going to start with a 2B. Sharpen with my Helix Sharpen. And don't start with his outline. I've got my lamp on the left of me, because I'm a right-handed. If you are left-handed, you have your light on the right. The gas man's just come to do the reading for gas. So when I opened the door, he acted as though I was a virus. Oh my god, should I have a mask on or what? So I just got Neil on the case straight away and went poof. I can't risk catching COVID. I haven't been injected, I've been invited twice, but I'm not having it because the clot thing scares me. There was always going to be something. I'm just pressing really, really lightly with this pencil at the minute because I don't want to make any definite indentations into my paper in case I need to rub it out. My husband does come in and start answering to me. I'll try and pause as quick as possible, but we have no way of knowing when each other's on record, so I interrupt his sometimes and he interrupts mine because he does pyrography and I do art. well, I mean, I do, he does art, obviously, it's an art part of him, but I mean, he works on wood and I work on paper, basically. But anyway, I'm using a Faber Castell 2B black matte 11112. Don't know if that helps for doing this outline. It's got quite dark eyes. It's got a beautiful light highlight there. I've drawn for so long. I haven't drawn and used graphite over a year, I think it is. Give me the motivation to draw again, but I really wanted to draw for a French Bulldog. My key workers asked me at all, because I told them my motivation and mojo is just totally gone, and I don't know why, I don't know what's happened, and she said to me, right, I'm going to set you a goal to draw me a tiger, and I'm not drawing the tiger, I'm drawing a French Bulldog, so a bit of difference there, and just flicking like hairs. I do believe in like building these up, because it always looks better when you, rather than some people just shade it first and then put the hairs on the top, but I like to give a flick of hair underneath for all, because like dog's hairs aren't shaded underneath and then flicked on top. They're rows and rows and rows of tiny little hairs. So I try not to go in uniform, because they're not all totally straight and all going in one direction. So just follow that direction of the fur. If you see some going in a different way, but I can't on this bit because it's so dark. It's black, actually, it's totally black, so you can't see any hairs, but they know they are hairs, obviously, because, but French Bulldogs have like wrinkles, and this is a wrinkle, inside a wrinkle. as well, though you're not making it look dark yet. It will eventually, like here as well, in between ears, like dark hair. It comes around. Each other to death sometimes, because he's learned so much in this past god knows how long since lockdown about our art. He tells me a lot of things that I already know, and it's like yep. There, so I'm going to darken that bit up first, and then I'll come around with one layer of this 2B again. One thing you can't stop when you've got dogs and stuff is like someone comes to the door, my dogs are gonna go mental, as you've just heard, so I do apologize for that. A lot of people will probably edit it out, but I'm not that techno snavvy, so
every 22nd hand wash them in together. Every sanitizer that is searched for them has been stopped the spread of COVID-19. Because anyone can spread it. Everything we're doing is making a difference. Let's keep going. Stay home. Protect the NHS. Save lives.
I know what you were doing last night. Not sleeping. Whether you're a new mum or you just can't sleep, say
still using this 2B pencil and still flicking.
Concentrate. It visibly corrects the appearance of skin damage caused by 30 days of poor sleep. Spend £75 at kiehl's.co.uk.
Flicking if you struggle to keep a light out, just hold the pencil further up the barrel.
Tap now to learn more.
And it'll help you.
While stocks last, T's and C's apply.
Keep a lighter hand. Right, now I'm going to find an HB pencil. Or, yeah. I'm just tired of having to pause this now because people keep speaking or stuff. Right, I'm going to use a HB pencil now. Go over the top again. Once I started doing this, that I'd start enjoying it, but it's not coming to me yet. Maybe because of all the interruptions. Right, I want to go up and try and find my 4B mechanical pencil now. If I can, without dropping everything. Yeah. Use a mechanical pencil now because the dark lines are so fine. Dark under here. Lightly still, not pressing on. Don't want to lose the tooth of the paper. I'm going to put these into hourly slots like my husband does with his pyrography. Anybody's interested in his pyrography, if you type in Flames Pyro Art on YouTube, you'll find him. He's really good. Really good. I'd say he's better than me. And he's only been doing it a year, so he's going to be heavenly when he's been doing it 5 years or so, 6 years, as long as me. I've had a year or more of a break. I used to do it as a job, and now I just do it for fun. Only because I don't want to do and bore everyone. Or me, and not bore everyone, but like give people poor work. Using H on this bit because it's a highlight and it's really light. Well, it's a lot lighter than the rest of it. Stipple brush it. Stipple brush, but I mean, like this. It's got a tiny, tiny, tiny bit of like, if you can see it, a tiny bit of brush on the end, and it just, if you lightly and go over it, it just pushes all that graphite underneath. Underneath the tooth, the paper. So that I don't get any of the dark onto the light. I'm just going to stipple a bit of this fur under as well. Again in little lines. Get a little brush. Don't know where it's gone now. Lost it. I've lost my little brush. I'll have to get another one. Put my just move my time lapse out of the way then. Little brush. It's just a makeup brush, as you will. And just brush it in to your thingies, into your okay, sorry, into your God, what are they called? What's it called? Oh my god, shut up. I know how he feels now, and I do it to him all the time. So what was I doing? I was stroking with this brush just to blend in this pencil that I've already put down. This also gives you an HB type blend into the white paper, so that you can work with that as well. So as you notice, I'm not really going into the eye on this because I want to do the eye with the pencil and not have to move the graphite around with the brush on the eye bit, just around just the fur bit, the strokes, just push them out, blend them so that it looks soft. Right, and then I'm going to get my 4B again and darken up this eyeball again. I hope you can see this. Why does it look white there on the video? I don't understand that. See, look, when I take my lamp away, no, that's better. It's weird, I hit the light in the wrong way, so you can see now that I'm darkening this bit up around this bit, like around this eye, and bringing this down. Can you hear him? He knows I'm recording now as well. Little bugger. Sorry if you can hear the dogs going in. Right, picking my 2B back up again and coming back in here now to darken all this back up. Because it'll make it even darker. It's not a really standout dark, but underneath there is. But later I'll show you the tactic to getting that really dark. Right, underneath is this bit is, I'm gonna get my 4B mechanical again, because this is really dark. This line above his eye. I'm taking it, this little dog is a boy in my head. It comes round, and but it's like white there, so won't make that dark. But I'm going to bring that down and darken that up. Keep it going round, and then I'm going to make sure that I keep them lines there, because that's where his hair is coming out. and it is dark, or darker there. I'm gonna bring it up to one. Something wrong here. That's better. And it's dark. Like, I'm still keeping my first rocks of this dark bit here. With this mechanical 4B pencil. I'm going to bring some of these in here. Just quick flashes of black because they are very... You don't have to do every hair for hair. Leave these bits white because there are white ones there. And then he has dark ones again under here. Quite uniform there. I use the word uniform as in straight lined together. And these dark bits here, coming up here. I usually don't like doing around dog's eyes. Don't like the around bit. I like the inside bit, but don't like the around bit. I usually cross over my lines here to make it so it's not looking too uniform. And then it's sort of like he has a line that comes over here, carries on round and up there, round and up there. And remember, all this is dark too. I'm pressing a little bit harder with this pen now, pencil. Supposed to be concentrating on the eye, and I just keep flitting. See what I mean? Right, so now I'm gonna get my HB pencil because it's quite light under this line in here. No, I'm not gonna use my 2H. 2H is quite light, but it's not too light. So for now, I'm gonna use 2H on this bit. Around the eye, this little hole, this little gap, and again I'm going to put it in here as well for the highlight. So it's like use the 2H as well to get that over, like HB or 2H, whatever you used on underneath into the grain of the paper, because you don't press too hard, you're just sort of like pushing it under the grain of the paper without even indenting. If I rub this off now, you would barely see a line because I've barely touched the paper until I start pressing on a little bit deeper You probably see my 4B lines, but that'll be it. Because these 4B lines I do press on a little bit, but not too hard. As you can imagine, if I did press on with the mechanical pencil, the lead would just break because it is a 0.5 mechanical pencil, so you can't really press on very hard. Then there's a line here. It comes up and over like that, and then that's really light there. So I'm going to try and just put it in real lightly with this 4B, if that's at all possible with a 4B pencil. Right, and then it's like HB that. And HB. Can I have a HB? Take my HB mechanical pencil because these are hairs. So I'm gonna flick some hairs through the bottom, and it's about the end of this highlight where you stop seeing them flicked hairs, but it's still light. It's like his bottom eyelid, but it's still, which you know with dogs, they've still got hair right up to their eyes. Just bringing it down, and in the ear as well, because this is only light. Though I could have cheated and used a blending stump in the top bits, but and now I want to get 2B, so I'm like ruining on aim. Okay, right, 2B pencil, and I'm going to put some hair strokes in. Pressing a little bit harder now with these, with this pencil, just a touch harder, and trying to keep in a non-uniform motion, like moving and dashing about a little bit here and there, and so it's not in straight lines and you've not got loads of straight lines of hair, you've just got dots and dashes everywhere basically. Even though if you brush your dog, all its hair would be straight, well, mostly straight, but it isn't. Especially this dog, and he is darker around this bit, so I'm going to press on that a little bit harder to remind myself that I need to keep this bit really quite dark, because it comes up into this bit. Which again is quite dark. So, right, don't want to ruin the tooth of my pencil work at the minute, so I'm going to cheat and use a very thin black, because it is dark underneath his eyelid, and I'm going to try and get that darkness with this. By pressing on harder with this very thin pencil. It very thin is by polychromos, I think. It's very thin, think the favourite paint is Barricormos. If you look for Palicormos, they're within range. It's quite a hard pencil, so you can press almost really very hard and it just does not break. And that's one of the things I like about it. So you can almost just make your mark and make sure you know that that's where you, that's where your darks are. Right, so HB now. Circle round. I don't think that's right. That's quite sharp. Now HB I'm going to put into this eye to make it glossy. This might go over an hour, this video, I'm not sure, because I want to get around the eyeball done and show you this bit is very, very straight. Well, not straight, but it's got a definite line to it. Even come out a little bit actually, so it might come out a little bit more than that, so I might need to take that bit out of there, which I've just used a Tombow Monori razor to do that, and then put that bit back in. Tidy up all these edges. Then come back and do some more hairs with this HB pencil under here. Some more hairs in, which will definitely be going in non-uniform, because I'm going over my other ones, so I have no idea where I've put my other ones, if you know what I mean. So it sort of gives it a 3D effect, so it stands out when you layer the hairs up. And I can go right up to there because it's only right underneath the eye that is lightest. I'm sorry if you can hear a really horrible noise, and I know it's annoying. It's annoying me. It's a water pump that my husband has to have in the back garden, unfortunately. Right, but you're over here, that stays white there, and then it's light here as well till it comes to here, and then it starts getting darker again. White, and then for this bit it needs to come up and over, so you take your hand above and push your pencil around so that it puts its part, the ears go towards that way. I know some people will be saying, well, that's only the underlayer, so why are you bothered? Why don't you just shade it? It's like I just said, there's many layers to a dog's fur, to a dog's undertone. So, don't just shade it. Put the ears in. Don't be lazy. I'm going to add another row of hairs on top of them. And then I'm going to get my blender, which is a colourless blender by Prismacolor, I think. Colourless blender, it's not very sharp. It is now. And then I'm going to pull these out a little bit, really lightly. Drag them out into the bare spare paper, and these as well. Really lightly drag them out so there are no definite edges. Drag the graphite across the paper. I find holding my hand like that sometimes while I'm doing this really helps. I don't know why. It just helps you keep your hand on the paper. And again, up here, wherever you can see the dark and obvious lines, pull it out. Not so they look like they carry on, but the light hits the ends of them. Do a little bit in there as well. Got a few lines in here as well, so with that bit of graphite I've got on the end of that, I might use that to just put them scarce little lines in this white bit. Then I'm gonna get my HB. I'm gonna small circular motions. I'm going to put the corner of his eye in. Which carries on up here. Small circular motions, really lightly, but not too light. You need enough pressure on your pencil to get the lead down. Carries on and it goes up and away, up and away. Make sure you've got enough graphite there. And then get me pencil again and drag that. Out as it hairs too. One of my dogs is breathing very strange. Oh well. What's the matter? Okay. Faber castell. Yes, I do cheat, and this is the tip I was talking to you about, how to get your blacks black, is use a polychrome or a Faber castell. I'm just gonna go around these black bits with this really lightly, I may even get a black pen, a normal black fine liner pen, and blacken around the eye. Around the top of his eye with this first, because he's jet black. All the way to the end. Use a fine liner tip, and then I'll use a bit of this as well in the ear. Around, use a little bit in here, and under here. Now you have to be careful because it's pen and you won't be able to get it off. So you've got to be so careful that you keep the line where you want it to go. And that is about right. And he's really dark in the corner of his eye here as well. So I'm going to use that black for there too. And under there. Some lines. Here the black, and there's where I leave my black fine liner. Come back in with my polychromos and go over that black pen. So we'll try and teach you something in these small clippets of lessons. In his fur here, he has like markings where the furs sort of clump together. He has more of them down at this end. There's a few here. still using my black polychromos. It definitely has a black line there. And he has a few coming off to there. And one definite line there. There. And leading down to there. Go over that pen with the black polychromos in the corner and bring it out so it's more rounded. And I might even darken this up. Now I know it's definite with this polychromos black. Don't commit yourself to using polychromos or a pen until you definitely know that what you're doing is correct, because you won't get them off. Well, you can get the polychromos off, but you won't get the pen off very easily. So, right, now I'm gonna use the brush again and try and brush into here, under here. That noise is really irritating. I could scream. Got an headache as well. Not good. Right. Oh, yeah, a bird. I'm gonna use the brush again like I did before and blend all the hairs so that they're not too obvious, and it helps with the background as well. It gives it a tonal value, almost of what it is. So you can use a light pencil really and your Tombow Mono Eraser to pull out lines once you've spread, but this is mainly to get the edges of the fur soft like so. So that's basically the eye, that eye, nearly done, and we'll come back and flip through eventually, because when I do the here and whatever next, I will probably notice something different about the eye that really needs doing, and I'll come back and do it. So, and then I'm going to get this blender, such a blending stump, just like paper rolled up into a blender, and I'm gonna pull the colour through from this eyelid onto this bit here so that it's not as dark as the middle or the eyeball, but it is there. That bit there's a highlight, so I'm leaving that bit there, and that bit's a highlight coming down here. This is lighter, so I'll get my Tombow Mono Eraser and pull out some hairs with that. Just a bit low. They'll probably end up getting covered back up again eventually, so I'll have to come through and do them again. But that's no problem, because that's a good thing in a way. Give a few hairs with my Tombow Mono into these light parts. See how it pulls the hair, the blending that you've just done with the brush. It pulls it back off. So you can basically, you can go in, and that's give you like more of a layer, if you know what I mean. So when you go in then with your, like your 2H or whatever, you can go around them Tombow Mono lines and find them, or send a line through one of them. Lines that you've just took out. I'm using a 2H again now and just putting hairs in. He is black and HB. When you look at him, he is like two tonal. He's either black or HB. So but you can't just go in with black and HB, you've got to make it. Now I'm just brushing that through to make it soft again. So there we have the French Bulldog's eye. And we are on just over 1 hour, so I'm going to leave that bit there, and I will come do this bit and the ear hopefully in the next hour. I'll try anyway. It's not too much of a dark here, so it shouldn't be too much work. So depending on, I might get this bit and all that done. We'll see. So I'll leave it at that for now for this lesson. But yeah, that's it from Didi for the hour of learning how to draw a brand French Bulldog. So thanks guys for watching. I hope you're still subscribed, and I'm sorry it's took me so long to get back to you all. I do value your patience, and I value your subscribing, and I value everything. So I think you're all amazing, and I hope you're all staying safe out there. So thanks guys, I'll catch you in the next recording. Okay, thanks guys, bye.